best sales rep.
Most welcome, all. Good evening, everybody. Thank you very much for coming from the National Gallery of Canada for this great Thursday. Merci beaucoup d'être là, les amigos of Canada. My name is David Galanders. I'm in the education department here. I want to welcome you to this first session of the new season of Creative Thursdays. Je suis David Galanders du département d'éducation et je suis là pour vous remercier d'être là et vous souhaiter la bienvenue à cette première session. David Kearn, who is an Ottawa painter, and David knows a thing or two about the work of Paul Gauguin. Nous accueillons l'artiste italien David Kearn, qui est un peintre qui sait quelque chose sur le travail de Paul Gauguin. Et là, ce soir, pour nous parler de, dans le cadre de l'exposition Gauguin Portrait, il va nous parler du dessin de portrait, et puis surtout de la couleur, de la manière dont Gauguin utilise la couleur. David's going to talk to us tonight about portrait drawing in conjunction with the exhibition Gauguin Portraits. He's going to talk to us about a little bit about Gauguin's work, I think, but certainly a lot about color and a lot about portrait drawing. We have two models in the front here, Dwayne and Janine, and we thank them for being here tonight. And you can come and get supplies at the materials tables to my left and over there to my right, where you have boards and all the other drawing materials that you need to draw live from the model. Voilà, j'ai assez parlé. Thank you again for being here tonight. You have a wonderful night. Et puis je vous présente David Kearn. Thank you.
So thank you for the wonderful introduction. I'm just delighted to be here and be part of the Gauguin Portrait Summer. We all like looking at faces. Like we're hardwired to look at people, right? So that as soon as you look at people, all facial recognition, our relationship with people comes in, and we dive straight into the features, right? But that's a little bit of a mistake of yours. You know, we've got all this gray matter that's got to be housed in enough space that we can actually. That it actually creates something that looks human. So we tend to underestimate those things. So starting off with a very general basis, without dealing with the features, tends to work out well. I think that's color works well with lights and blacks. So before I actually put much expressive color on, I'll just look at the lights and darks as well. So I might use a little bit of color here, and perhaps in the dark areas, maybe I'll use a bit of purple. So I didn't put a lot of color in my darks. Don't be afraid to color in the dark areas, right? And as well as that, perhaps I'll put some lights in as well. And so I've started this general form. It's not my main preoccupation.
I can't imagine.
So now we get the fun part. Now we can actually work with a little bit more. And by the way, you might try to just add a little bit of definition as you go to actually at this stage, you could certainly go into some definition for the features. Right? So organizing the white lights. And it's certainly a lot more satisfying to work on eyes and noses and mouths when the space is already organized, because it's not a lot of fun sort of having to move things a little bit later. So I always find that it's good to get those large shapes right, get some lights and darks in before worrying tremendously about confidence. They are so, maybe that's good enough. So now we've got the plan that we can actually put in some expressive talent. So Google would have well understood this idea of confidence, that working with colours across the colour needs grammar. And you can see this in a number of his portraits. So I'm going to put in some expressive colour. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of take a little bit of a different approach. Sort of one side to the other, right? Because oftentimes it's probably, you know, sort of a thing that I look for. There's a side that's dark, there's a side that's light. So creating some difference between the lights and the darks, that and the different side of the portrait tends to work out well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say, well, on one side, I'm going to do predominantly sort of put some colour in, or make some colours green and red perhaps on this side, right? So maybe I'll just add in some nice expressive sort of colour predominantly. And so perhaps on this side I'll make it more sort of oranges and blues, work in some, just gives you a nice sort of hint of crown. And so that is one way of tackling, sort of getting some nice bright colours into your portrait. And then probably don't want to have waited until now, but we have these wonderful ink pens as well. So it's always it's nice to actually emphasize things to wine. In fact, we'll get a sentence and say that wine gives people emphasis. Right? So he uses wine to send a message, and he probably would have put line work in along a lot earlier than myself, but I'm going to add some in that. So in just like sort of a few steps, like roughing in the large shapes, putting in some lights and darks, so quite a lot of complementary colour, sort of with, in this case I've been using sort of blues and oranges and reds and greens. We've created a sort of very, very, very quick and gestural sort of portrait study. When that's sort of pulling some things from Gauguin, some things from just some general portrait practice and use of colour. And that will be fun to just come around and see some of the things that we're doing.
I've been recording my leg.
Oh, have you? That's good to know.
Oh, I'm telling you. He's going to say, what's all this black? What's wrong with the camera? I hope you don't mind if I take a little bit of a look at your art, because I'm really impressed with that. People are having a blast, Kathy.
People are having a blast, and you know what? Hmm? There's some really amazing art around here.
I know.
I'm so impressed by people.